every game. I think that his team knows that I'm a huge threat, and they feel like he can beat me. There's some easier fights out there. But, Eddie Hearn and Matchroom Boxing and Top Rank have worked together on numerous fights this year. So I think the fight could be made, but I think this team just feels like it's easier opponents.
I know it's not as fun to talk about what if the opponent of the fight actually be in here, but how would the Lomachenko fight go right now with you at 21?
It's many different ways that the fight will come out. I would never know. However the fight plays out, I'm bigger, I'm stronger, I'm faster, I'm more athletic, and I got youth on my side.
Do you feel like you'll be able to stay at 35 long enough for?
No. I don't feel like I won't stay at 135. That much longer. I said this before that 135 wasn't easy for me to make. World title or not, I was gonna move up soon.
Do you think that's disappointing for the fans? They never got to see that fight. I know you wanted it.
I do think that a lot of fans wanted to see the fight at the end of the day. I feel like that fight doesn't make or break. I mean, it would be great to have to make that fight happen. I think we're going to
off the good man. Now with the fight on the 9th, it's gonna be a whole lot of people streaming in. Do you think with a performance you put on, you could even get people who don't care about boxing, who are just tuning in for Logan Paul to cross over to your fan base?
Yes, and that's why I feel like it was alright for me to go on the card, because it was a whole new audience, a lot of new fans that I can gain, by being on the undercard and going there, put on a great performance, and hopefully still some fans.
Do you know who the opponent is, and does it really matter, since it feels like it's more of a showcase fight?
Some things going on with the opponent, it was kind of hard, because at first it was supposed to be for an interim title, and now it's for a world title, so that's a whole different type of opponent, the fighter will have to be ranked, in the top 15 and things like that. But I do have an opponent now, and I feel like, it really didn't matter who I thought I was going to go in there and make the adjustments. That's how I train. I didn't train for a specific fighter. I go in there to make the adjustments and do what I do.
And I wanted to ask you, too, about Ryan Garcia. Fights on the same map, the zone, fights Saturday night. Do you find Ryan to be on the same level as you and a Shakur Stevenson and that kind of thing?
Yeah, I think Ryan is actually a really good fighter. He gets a lot of flack, for making Instagram videos making these type of videos, but I think that he's a really good fighter, and I think that he's improved since being with Canelo's team. Hopefully one day we can make that fight happen. I think that will be a huge fight between me and him. Hopefully it happens sooner than later.
What makes him a top talent though, being that you fought him 6 times?
I mean, he has a lot of experience. A lot of people don't know that. Ryan probably has 14 national titles. He was a top amateur. Coming out of the amateur ranks. Has probably double the amount of amateur fights that I have, so I think that his experience plays a big role.
Because it seems like you said, the followers and stuff, it's like people aren't, because of that, starting to take him as seriously do you and some of the other young guys.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like in the pros, some of the guys have improved a little bit more and showed more in their fights, but I think that Ryan is.
Double it up, Dina! Double it up! 415, last stand. Devin. Nobody do it like you on the planet. Top choice road boy.
Oh, baby, this is me, this kid.